Hello, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Rudy and thank you so much for being here. As you can see, we are not in our usual setup. We are currently in Los Angeles. Yes, I am in LA with Ulta Beauty right now and I am here as a mentor for the Ulta Beauty Collective class of 2023. I was in the 2022 class and they asked me to come back and help out with the current class, which was so freaking nice. And I found this out like literally 2 weeks ago. So this is kind of an impromptu trip to LA, but it has been absolutely jam packed. Basically, this has been a networking trip rather than like a typical brand trip. So we have already met so many brands and gone to their headquarters and networked with some of the brands, including all of the brands at L'Oreal. We spent an entire day, like 9 hours, at the L'Oreal headquarters. And then today we went to Way, e.l.f., Keys Soulcare, and Well People, which was really, really fun. I actually am skipping, or currently am skipping, an event that the collective is at. They're on a boat in Malibu with Osea. I have like really bad seasickness in general. You guys know I don't travel well and I was feeling really tired. So I decided to skip out on that and take my time because we have another event this evening. We are going to the Half Magic launch party for Ulta Beauty. So if you don't know the brand Half Magic, I have a giant bag of their stuff right here. It was started by Donnie Davy and it is a brand that is synonymous with the show Euphoria. And she basically used and created these products in collaboration with A24 and the Euphoria creators. And they are launching at Ulta. So we are going to celebrate the launch. I'm gonna do something totally crazy and different. It's really not gonna be crazy, but something different with my makeup than I usually do for this event. I wanna have some fun with it. I'm thinking like, I'm wearing an orange dress. So I'm thinking orange and pink eye, just doing something fun because why not? Like, this is the exact type of event that I feel like I could actually pull out some of my fun eyeshadows. So I thought we could get ready together and just catch up because I know it's been a little bit since we've done a sit down video together. So I've already got my skin prep on. I'm wearing the Rode moisturizer and I'm gonna go in with the Milk Hydro Grip primer. This is a mini. I think you can get this as a sample size, but y'all know I'm obsessed with minis. But I am sorry that I've not been as available online as of recent with the freckle pen launch, which if you're new here, I launched a freckle pen literally last week. It's been absolutely amazing, but it's been taking up a lot of my time and I just haven't had the capacity to film my general YouTube videos along with everything that's been happening there. So I'm absolutely planning on continuing to post on YouTube. Don't even worry about that. But I just needed a little bit of time to have the launch go well, keep up with what I wanna do next, et cetera, et cetera. But don't worry, babes, I'm here for you. You know that. Okay, so I am gonna do my eyebrows next, which I just realized I probably should have done this first because I have this idea for tonight that I might do for TikTok to put glitter in my eyebrows because she has this incredible product called the Glitter Pills. And they're basically like a clear, transparent glitter base. And look how pretty this is. I just think this would be perfect for putting it in your eyebrows. And this shade in particular is just like multicolored beautifulness. So I might try that out. And in the spirit of that, I'm going to do a fake lamination on my brows. I have been seeing a lot of people use the Got to Be Glued to laminate their brows. And I actually use this for my slick back hair. And I just wanna try it. I'm really curious. So I'm just gonna use like the littlest bit. I'm not really a laminated brow look type of girl. I also am like, I have a mirror right behind the camera. So sorry if I'm not looking directly to camera because I have to make sure I'm doing this well. But from what I've seen, you just apply like the tiniest, tiniest bit. And I think I'm just gonna warm it up on the back of my hand so that it's not completely white going into my eyebrows. And I'm gonna just rake it through. I am really not a laminated look girl, but I think for a glitter look for the brows, they should be laminated or look like really sleek, you know? I have really wiry brows, so I think I might need even more than that. Like, I kind of think I need a lot. I am not used to this at all, but we are gonna make it work. Designer, to make it work. I've heard that once you do find the shape that you like, they will stay, which is what I want. I just want them to basically stick to my forehead, which again is not my usual look at all. Like, look at that. That is not my usual look at all, but I think It could be kind of fun and funky and fresh and different. Why not? It's not looking so funky, or it's not looking so fresh. It's looking more funky than fresh, if I'm being honest. But I think it's just because I'm not really used to it. But it is drying. It is drying. Okay, I'm gonna leave that one as is and do the other one and see what happens. This party tonight is at a club. You guys know I'm obviously not a club kind of girl, but I'm going and I'm doing the damn thing. It's at a club called Bootsy Bellows, and like, you know, I'm not stupid. I know that that's like the club, the current club that the peeps are loving and laughing and living at. So I am excited to see it. And as far as I know, because it is Donny Davy, there could be some celebs there. Like, what if Zendaya showed up, you guys? I will put in the comments if Zendaya showed up, but let's be honest, you know she didn't. What if her and Tom Holland came running through the building and they were like, hey, we're here to celebrate. I don't know how girls make this look so good. My friend Scout does laminated brows and she's on this trip and she makes them look so good. That one's okay. Once they're in place though, you guys, they will not move because I'm trying to like shape this one a little more and it ain't. Turns out it ain't. Okay, so now I think I need to take a little like cleanser and clean off some of my skin because I've got to be all over me, so I'll be right back. Guess what, you guys? While I was cleaning off my got to be, my room service came and you know what I got? French fries and cookies. You guys, these French fries are so good. They're just waffle fries, but something about them is special. I'm happy. Moving on. Okay, so I'm gonna let these dry down before I do anything else to them and just see what happens. I used this base combination today, earlier today, and I really, really liked it, so I'm gonna do it again. This is the new Hourglass Veil Hydrating Skin Tint, and my face is tan right now, and my body's tan. I got a self-tan at home, and you can see that my face is quite a bit lighter and more pink, and they actually put this in our bag, and I'm glad they did. This is the Lumi Glotion from L'Oreal, and it's in their deepest shade, which is Deep Glow, and I like to use it to make my foundation a little bit darker because it also adds a little bit of that glowy tint. So I'm actually just gonna put this on the back of my hand and then apply because, ooh, I have some got to be on my hand still. That stuff does not come up, you guys. She's got to be. I'm literally putting in just the tiniest little dollop of that, and then I'm gonna mix it together and then apply it in sections on the face. This Hourglass skin tint is so, so pretty. It's so hydrating and it just feels so nice on the skin. It kind of feels thick like a tinted moisturizer would, but it has more of like a gel consistency to it. Oh, it's so nice. I wear shade 8 typically, like when I'm not self-tanned, but I'm just gonna add like some of the regular shade on my forehead. But it's easy to mix other things with it. Like I just mixed in the Glotion and it worked very well this morning. And it's just absolutely gorgeous. I'm super impressed with it. I think I talked about it a little bit already on Instagram and TikTok. If you want to follow me over there, it is at the Rudy Berry on Instagram and at Rudy Berry on TikTok. I don't want to go too high coverage because I don't want the skin to take away from the rest of the look. So I just want it to be natural. And I am going to use a powder to set my skin today because we are going to be out on the town. It is hot. It is hot, hot, hot out. And I want it to last. I will say I find myself using kind of a lot of product with that, and it doesn't seem to be very big. 1.1 fluid ounces, so actually it's not bad. It's about the size of a classic foundation, but because it's thicker consistency, you might go through it a little bit quicker, whereas like a more fluid foundation, you wouldn't. This is a skin tint. There is no SPF in this product. Similar to the Summer Fridays, no SPF, I just tend to go for skin tints that are without SPF. I don't know, I like to be able to put my SPF on beforehand and decide what level I want or if I wanna wear a skin tint at night. I can appreciate the fact that there's no SPF in it. So before we go in with concealer, I'm actually going to do my eyes so that I can clean up any leftover mistakes. I probably should have done that before. But again, I'm really out of my element right now because I don't usually do this type of stuff. You guys know. I'm out of it. So like I said, my dress is orange, and it's so funny because obviously Ulta's colors are orange and pink, And I really didn't mean to do this, but I grabbed these two ColourPop single shadows. This one is in Bubble Bee. It's this really cool orange shade. And then I also grabbed this pink, which is kind of like a topper, in Roy G. Biv. It's got glitter throughout it. And a couple of my friends have worn this recently and really, really liked it. So I just thought it could be really fun. Also, ColourPop single shadows, they have a really strange consistency. And I think it could be fun to play around with a brush and see how they apply and then layer them. So my vision kind of, I think, is going to be taking the orange and just kind of having it all over the lid and then having the pink really packed on into like a wing shape and kind of just blow it out. I also got this when we were at the L'Oreal Studios. This is the Ultimate Paradise Shock Palette from NYX. And I noticed that it had some of those oranges up there as well. So I might go in with those as well to see how the blending is. I'm actually gonna start with that now that I think about it. I'm gonna start with this shade here. This is in shade three, just an orange. And I don't have any eye primer because I don't wear eyeshadow ever. So I'm gonna do just a little bit of concealer. As you can tell, you guys, I don't have the vision for this at all. I wish I did. I wish I was a girly who just knew exactly what to do when she sees color, but I don't. But you know what? That's okay because we're just gonna play around and have fun with it, and whatever comes out of it, I can make it work. Designers make it work. And I am using the Colfi concealer today on my eyes, so hopefully it looks good. I'm going to also set this a little bit with just some pressed powder from Kosas, just so my powders blend a little bit easier. If I don't talk for a while, it's because I'm deep in practice. I basically want to start with the little smallest amount of color that I can get and then build up, which is so funny because like Donny Davy goes in with super like crazy colors right away and just goes for it, and I love that. But obviously she is a professional makeup artist, but I can't wait to see some of the looks that people pull out tonight because there are some incredible makeup artists on the 2023 collective that just, they're gonna absolutely kill it. And this one is more of like a brown orange, which is good because I think for an all-over transition it can help blend the two, pink and the orange together. Which I don't even know if I'm gonna look good in pink and orange. Like, I might look crazy, but we're gonna see. I'm now gonna dip into this orange shade with that same brush and just see what comes up, you know? See what feelings arise. And I'm going to, oh yeah, that's orange. I'm gonna take that all over the lid and through the crease just lightly with this big brush because I just want like a wash of orange. And then I'm going to really build that up in the crease and then put the pink right on top, just on the lid. I did a look similar to this on my friend Erin for my freckle pen shoot, and I did hers half and half. I did like the inside of her eye pink and the outside orange, and it looked so good on her. But she is a blonde, and I am a fake redhead, so should have thought this through. I also am glad I'm doing my eyes first because I want to see how my blush and lips would counteract with this color, you know? Okay, I think for now, I'm gonna go in with my finger into the, oh, I just put my nail right in it, into the orange shade to build it up a little bit more. Just because, why not? Like, I'm going to a crazy, fun, cool club. Let's be colorful for once in my freaking life. It's very pretty. It's giving like orange gold. Now I'm gonna go in with pink, because this is what I'm really most excited about, if I'm being honest with ya. And I'm gonna do something similar where I'm feathering it towards the front. I'm so sorry if this is not interesting to you because I know tutorials are not really the vibe anymore, but I just feel like a kid and I'm playing with makeup and it's so fun every once in a while just to do something different. And I'm so grateful that I have this opportunity and that Ulta trust me enough to be a mentor for the class because I just love it. I love Ulta. I love working with them. They're just so easy to work with because they get it. Just get it. And also Ulta is getting so many good brands right now. It's actually crazy. I think that looks cool. Basically what I'm saying is if you put glitter on your eye, you'll look cool. And sorry the sun is going down, but we will persevere. I think I'm going to take a little bit of this pink shade here into the crease as well, just to mix up the definition a little bit, because right now it's very orange and I do want a splash of pink in there. Okay, for now, we're gonna leave it because we can do the rest of the face and then decide how we wanna fix this later. You know, everything looks better when you put on mascara. So we're gonna see how we feel towards the end and what we wanna add for the inner corner, liner, all that stuff. So next I'm gonna go in with concealer and clean up this line and just add concealer in the places I want to brighten. And of course I'm using the Colfi concealer. They actually just did a shade extension on this line. And I know that a lot of people weren't able to find their shades originally, so I'm really hopeful that people will this time because this is such a good concealer and I really want to be able to recommend it to as many people as possible. And I'm in shade Cocoa Crush in the concealer. It's so funny because Kevin, my best friend Kevin, he is on the Collective this year and because he lives in LA, he goes to events like this literally all the time. And so he's like, oh, it's not a big deal, da da da. And I'm like, yes, it is. It's a huge deal. Like, to me, it is, because in Nashville, we don't get very many events. And I would love it if we did get more. But when I come out here, it's such a treat. And Reed and I are actually coming in a couple weeks. And it's not like I want to move here. That's not what I'm saying. Because I really like having a yard and space for my dogs and to get away from like the superficial reality that is LA, which like it just is. But it is fun to come visit and to meet the brands that I love working with. It's giving Black Swan in kind of a fun way. I'm going to add just a little bit more concealer. I've actually been layering it with this concealer I got in France. That doesn't exist in the US yet. The Best Skin Ever Glow. I talked about this, I think, in my haul. Because it's got a little bit of an orangey undertone, so I feel like it helps correct some of this under eye sharp darkness. Feeling good, feeling good. My lips are feeling dry though, and we just went to e.l.f., luckily, and I grabbed their new Squeeze Me lip balms. These are tiny, you guys. Like, so tiny, and you can see that, like, it's only filled up to here. So like, I hope they're like literally a dollar or less, like $2, because if it's any more than that, they are really nice though. They feel like very similar to the Laneige lip balms, the glowy lip balms. So I'm gonna do a combination of powder and cream tonight, just to really have all my ducks in a row. So I'm actually gonna use a brand we went to today for my bronzer. This is the Well People bronzer. This is the Supernatural bronzer, and I'm in the shade Neutral Tan. And I'm gonna put this on the back of my hand and then use it. But I love this color because it has a little bit of a red undertone. So it ends up looking almost like a blush, like a blushy bronze. And on my skin tone, it looks really, really good. I just love a bronzer that has a little bit of a warm, like rosy undertone, not necessarily red. And I definitely don't like ones that have a greenish undertone or more like contour style because I don't contour. So it doesn't make sense for me to have a grayish toned bronzer. I'm so sorry, I'm realizing the sun is legitimately going down and we will soon be doing our makeup in the dark. And for that, I apologize. Cause I am stupid and I left my light, my extender light at home, like on my counter, like a dum-dum. I really wanna make sure I'm pulling everything up because I want this look to be really snatched, which it's impossible not to be because my Botox is literally so fresh and so clean and it feels so good. I know I'm kind of rushing, but I feel like with cream, I just have it down to a science at this point. You know, I just know what I'm doing. So for blush, I can't decide if I think a more muted pink would look better or more of my classic dark. I think maybe the NARS. And then I'm going to put another Well People product on top of that. This is the NARS Afterglow Liquid Blush in the shade Dolce Vita. And no matter what I do, I feel like I have to wear this. It's funny because I got a lot of comments on my short on this product that people were saying like, oh, I've heard bad things about this, like that it's not pigmented enough. But I love it for the reason that it is really sheer and buildable. Like, it's impossible to mess up and it gives you the most natural finish. I like it more than I like the Say liquid blushes. Because again, it's easier to blend. It's more of like a gel style product. And it just looks like, on my skin, the shade Dolce Vita looks like a natural sun-kissed moment, which as you know, is my favorite thing in the world, so. Again, we're really going up with the blush and probably going overboard because it's me. So for highlighter, I have been using this tint from Catrice. This is the All Over Glow Tint, and I like it because it is really liquidy, but I don't like it because it kind of sits down very fast, which can be good if you are wearing, like, you want a long wear for a highlighter. So I'm just gonna put a bunch in my hand and build it up on my sponge and kind of roll it onto my cheeks right under my eyes and like where I would always put my highlighter, and just give myself like an all over sort of glow rather than putting it directly on my face. And just give myself some extra glow, but we are gonna put powder on top of this, so I'll probably put some more on before we're all said and done. The brows are literally, they are frozen. Frozen. Let it go, frozen. All right, now we're going to go in with our powder versions of each of those steps to lock it all in place. I started doing this recently because I found that I was needing to go from a day to night look, hashtag, kind of often recently, which doesn't usually happen to me. And I just would do cream during the day and powder at night, and it would last forever. So I feel like that idea should work even if I'm just doing it back to back right now. Having the cream on, setting it with powder, and getting sort of that double layer of color, one of cream, one of powder. So I'm using my mini of the Kosas Cloud Set under my eyes, and just to set some of those areas of the face, like my T-zone. I do have some glitter under my eyes, but honestly, I don't care because again, if there's a brand that you're gonna have glitter under your eyes for, it's gonna be this one, and it's fine. And then if you wanna add more glow back to your skin later, you always can do that with like a spray or a liquid highlighter in specific places. But I find that powder always looks best in the evening. So I like to use that more in the evening. Then for my powder bronzer, I'm gonna use the Hourglass Ambient Lighting. This is just the one I have that's a mini. This is in Luminous Bronze Light. It does a good job. I don't love it, but I am trying to go through it, and it is a product I've had in my travel kit for a really long time, and it does the job. And there are honestly not a lot of mini powder bronzers out there, strangely enough. And honestly, before I leave, there's a great chance that I add even more makeup than this, but you know, we're doing it together at this point. Lastly, for my powder blush, I'm going to use the Well People Super Powder Blush in the shade Hazelnut Harvest. I love these. They're so little, they're so easy to travel with. The colors are to die for, and they don't take away all of the glow on your face because they are more of a baked formula. So because of that, they don't kick up a bunch of powder and they don't set down super matte. They still have that satin sheen to it, and they layer really well over cream, which I love. This is always the one I go for when I need to go for like a day to night look. And I don't wear powder blush very often, you guys know that. I have legitimately no idea what I'm gonna do with my frickin' lips. I'm feeling pretty good so far. So let's finish up the eyes before we go on to lips and, you know, just like the final touches, like, I don't know, freckles. I know I'm going kind of fast, but, you know, it's me. I do have an idea for the inner corner, and it is a Half Magic product, and it is one of their eye paints. So pretty too. This is in the shade Baby Bunny, and it's their Chrome Addiction products. These are so pretty. And look at this one. It's like a light pink chrome. And I would put it on, but I don't want to, or I would like swatch it, but these last forever and I don't want to have to wash it off. So I think I'm just gonna put a little bit on and blend it with a little brush and see how that fancies me. I'm having so much fun. I think I'm actually just gonna pick up some on my brush and then go in with my inner corner. Oh yeah, kind of wanna put this on my brows too. Like, look at that. I don't even know if you can see just how iridescent it is, but it's crazy. It's just like this makeup line just makes you want to play like you were a kid, basically, which is so rare these days. Like, I'm always doing the same kind of look, which I love, but sometimes it's like, oh my gosh, to play with color. I wish this sort of stuff was acceptable like in the workplace so you guys could play with little fun glitters all the time. And I'm just gonna sort of blend this into the pink that's in the front. I'm not doing a very good job, if I'm being honest. Okay, I gotta clean that up because that looks bad. We'll get there, we'll get there. I'm not worried about it. Totally not worried about it. But when in doubt, add more glitter. I feel like that's what she'd say. You can already tell tonight's gonna be one of those nights where I have so much glitter in my eyes. This looks a lot better in person than it does on video. I just want everyone to know that. Another thing that we got that I was like, oh, this could be fun to use in my inner corner is the Jumbo NYX eye pencil, and this is in the shade Vanilla Ice Cream. It's kind of a white glitter, like a crystal glitter. And I was like, ooh, that's pretty. So I'm gonna layer that too, because why not? Let's make it super icy. Kevin is gonna see me and be like, what the heck did you do? And I'm gonna use a little bit of that on my nose to give a super highlighted look, and on my cupid's bow, just for fun. We're just having fun, right, girls? All right, let's slap on some mascara before things get out of hand even more. I'm gonna be kind of not crunchy, but like big and bold with the mascara. I'm using the Cali Ray Come Hell or High Water in the mini. But when you have a really colorful eye look, I think that it is useful to really pile on the mascara, because it just adds to, if you made any mistakes, it kind of covers them up. I think for now I'm gonna skip my bottom lashes and see if we want to go back and add some more, but I'm liking it. It's looking really pretty. It is kind of giving what I wanted it to give. And also, she has little diamonds that she gave us that we can add like rhinestones to our eyes and our face. And I'm like, oh my God, where do I want to put them? I saw her put one on either side of her nose, and I thought that was so cute and original, and I might do it. I might be going absolutely overboard, but why not? I keep saying that, but truly, why not? See how much better it looks with a little mascara. Honestly, you guys, mascara fixes everything. I know that people say tubing mascaras don't layer well, but as long as they're still like tacky, you can layer them. You just have to be a little bit quick about it, and you can't let it dry. But I feel like that's with any mascara, you know? Like, you just gotta put it on when you can. I think it looks really pretty, you guys. I really do. Especially from far away. It's like so chromey. Oh, cute! I really, really, really don't know what I'm gonna do with the lips. That might be a game time decision if I'm being totally H with you. But if I had to guess, it's gonna be like the Benetint with something over it, you know? You know me, I'm not gonna do anything out of character when it comes to the lips. When the eyes look like this, the lips have gotta be on point. So I'm going to go in with some freckles, and I'm gonna go kind of crazy with the freckles because I think, why not? Again, we're like going over the top here. And I like to take my freckles around my nose first and then kind of feeder them out. And I'm gonna pull them up like literally throughout my eyebrows, because I think I saw someone do that and it looked so cute. I just wanna be extra for one night in my life. I'm usually so tame when it comes to makeup, okay? Personality, you know I'm extra. I'm gonna send Reed a picture and he's gonna be like, what the hell? But he'll like it. He likes everything I do. He's actually on a golf trip right now with his friend, which is about the opposite of what I'm doing. Really shows our differences in personality. That is a freckled ass yacht. It's just getting cuter by the minute. I don't even know what to tell you guys. I'm feeling so cute. I'm very sweaty though, because I turned off the AC so that you could hear me. I feel like this is where I need to leave you, because I need to do the finishing touches after I finish eating and all of that. So I will come back when I'm finished with my hair and my outfit, and we'll do like a quick check-in so you can see what everything came out to be. But so far, this is where we're at. I think I might need to add a little bit more blush, of course. But I think the eyes are really pretty. Like, it's something I would not do, and it really turned out. And I think the brows look good too. So that's where I'm at. Kevin's not gonna be back for a little bit from the boat, so I have some time to relax, and I will be back in a minute. Okay, I'm sorry the lighting is so bad now because it's dark, but I have the finished product to show you. Let's see if the bathroom's any better. Oh yeah, we're better. Okay, so this is the finished makeup. I added rhinestones on either side of my nose, and I put glitter in my eyebrows. That's really all I added. And then with my hair, I did a little bun with these little antlers. I think they're so cute. It's very Gen Z, you know? The dress is actually just this little silk dress. I got it from Target last week, and I love it because it's not too tight on the stomach area. And the back has this really nice cowl neck to it. I'm wearing these pink lacy heels from Aloha's, which again match with the pink and orange eye. and with Ulta Beauty because I guess I'm Ulta vibes. And I am wearing my little Prada bag that I got in France. So that is the final look. I hope you like it. I know it's something very different for me, but it's fun to play around every once in a while. So I'm heading out. Absolutely love you, mean it, and I will talk to you in the next one very soon. Bye.